So I know you as a team member. I know you as a person who has worked with you on the manuscript as well. So, but to the audience who is watching this, would you like to introduce yourself?
I'm Vivek. You are a new irritating author. I hope so. And you are known by me by the book named Phantom Magician and the Tiger Palace. Basically, I am an engineer, aeronautical engineer, just namesake. So my passion lies somewhere along with the movies. So whenever I watch a movie or something related, reading a news, something related to that, I get gravitated towards that. So this made me write so many stories. And I don't want to just repeat the preface of my book. So only I'm just deviating from that. So if you read the preface, I have given everything. As far as this, that interest brought me to write so many stories and script. And one of the story and one of the script made into the story is this book. So let's hope how this goes on.
Well, I believe that your book will do great in the market. And I believe that it will be a good, very, very great success as well. So basically, you told me that films have been an inspiration for you to write scripts. And films movies have been the major driving force which made you write, you know, whatever you write, you're writing. You get inspired from movies, you get inspirations. So if you could tell me which kinds of movies have been taken into account in the creation of The Phantom Magician and Tiger Palace, you must have taken references and stuff, maybe.
Actually, as you may know, Tanish, previously I have made this book as a short PDF, something like that. This book was started in 2018, before I got married. So once I got married, the book got stopped. In the last COVID lockdown, I got plenty of time. So I had time to complete the story. When I published that, in that PDF, I have made around 3 pages of references, total movies, books, stories, games. Actually, that was some of the references, that those 3 pages were some of the references. Since I'm not so sure about publishing that in this overall, that was among the friends, right? But this is a whole scale of another level. So I'm not so sure. So that's why I edited out those pages while sending the manuscript. But if it is necessary, maybe in the next editions of this book, I might add those things.
That is amazing. So, yeah, you can
see. Main thing is very few movies. As while editing the books, you have said that somewhat similar to that Famous Five. Find out us.
Famous Five. I was referencing that because I felt like your book had the potential to be released in a sort of a series, like The Phantom Magician and Tiger Palace, then The Phantom Magician and something else, The Phantom Magician and something else. So that's what I felt was like Famous Five-ish about the. About the book.
Yeah. That's what the main concern of this. As I said, I wrote this story for a script, mainly for a web series. You might, I want to tell this. When I got the copy of my book, I opened it. The first thought come to my mind was, what? My book is so small. This is the small book I have written. No, I want to write a bigger book. So, then I thought, why it is so small? Because then, as I referenced so many other books, those had a bookish references, like explaining the surroundings and everything. But my main concern was to write the script for a web series. So in order for a web series, it should be a fast pacing and movement. Then only audience will watch that. So I edited out all the extra gems, or how to say, exaggerations from that story. So it is like this. Maybe as you said, Phantom Magician, something else in the next book that might come and add among the story itself.
Yes. So this is actually amazing. Like, you were writing it according to like a script, basically. So a script majorly focuses on the characters and their dialogues rather than the surroundings. The surroundings are like mentioned in the top of the way when they're telling the information about the set, like, okay, 3 people on the set, and then there are these forests and there are these trees and stuff. And then the conversation continues.
Time, like that.
Exactly.
Yeah, it could be like that. So that's what that I cut out from this book itself. So only it looks small. Okay, then I pacified myself. No. This is the main difference between other kind of similar books to my book and other kind of similar authors to myself. So if someone likes this book after buying this and reading this and they are expecting me, they would expect the similar content from me next time only. Not the same similar, you know, we go for a movie, we like an actor, we like a director. When we go for another movie, we would expect somewhat similar to that. If they got deviated from that, only and only if it is better, we would encourage it.
Appreciate
or else we will totally sham the movie or something like that. No. Hmm. So that's what I want. Okay, this book is small. Even many have told me that this is the size of our school diary.
Well,
your school diaries will be very, very short and for a daily, all that yearly calendar, everything will be. Yeah. So it is like that. Okay, fine. Myself a school diary. At least somehow remembered like that. Fine. That's good for me.
Yes, exactly. But I believe there are perks to a small book as well. Like, it is easy to carry around. It is easy to just take out and read. You know, like all those perks come up with having a small book.
Yeah, you know, one more thing, whenever I go to a bookshop, the first two things attract me to buy a book is the size of the book. If it is very, very smaller, I would suddenly buy it. And if it is an even greater, best book also, if it's bigger, I would hesitate to buy that. And second thing is images and a cover of the book. You know, many people would say, don't judge the book by its cover. But only the cover attracts the people. If the cover is good, at least they will turn, okay, what is this? You know, I'm that kind of guy. So I would buy like those books, everything like that.
Even I feel that, like, books, the covers are like the face of the book. If you are keeping your face well groomed and, you know, if you are wearing a good attire, then eyes automatically turn. People want to look at you. Basically, that's the same about books. If there is a very plain gray kind of a book lying around in a shelf, and then there is a very vibrant one, you know, it has a lot of colors, or it is more attracting, pleasing to the eye. Even though that book has like an average content and the grayish book has like, you know, world-class content.
Yeah.
Even then people would tend to buy that average book just because its cover was vibrant and just because due to pure aesthetics, like these days people love to keep books in their shelves as, you know, as pieces of jewelry or pieces of attractions.
Attractions
rather than, you know, for the content. Like they want to show their collection off. Like, okay, this is my collection of books. So vibrant, so beautiful and stuff. So these days I think books have been a bit degraded to that level. But there are classics, there are stuff which people should read out there. So yeah. I would just say that covers are as important as the content. Like the book cover, it has a lot of importance. And I feel even Vivek agrees to that point. So Vivek, I would like to ask you a very interesting question. Were there any initial reviews which you had to take care of, or were there any funny incidents along the line while writing the book?
See, again, one more thing, I would be repeating the preface content of my book. So the main thing is, certain things I wanted to mention, those thorn bushes while traveling in the village. I have had the same experience. Even now, my village roads are somewhat like that. I used to get that bumpy ride. So all those thorn tearing the shirts, that happened to me. Even actually, I have not mentioned in that book, but I got even scratches and some blood clot came out, something like that. So whoever might read that, they might imagine themselves going through some villages, no? So I wanted to create that experience because whichever I wrote in this book, it's somewhat related to me and what I have seen and seen up growing like that, no? So that's what I have written here. And as far as writing experience, I used to play many games. As I said, no, the 3 pages of references, I told no. So some of them are mainly Tomb Raider game, not Tomb Raider.
Tomb Raider, yeah.
That game series, one of the main inspiration. And of course, the main character is inspired from Dr. Strange and Constantine, both Marvel and DC.
Yeah.
So I was very much inspired by the fantasy and fantastical elements around me. Even I have read that Chronicles of Narnia and the Silver Chair. So that thing was also inspiration for this book. This book was actually started as a typing experience for me, not as intended for a story writing. Actually, this was started as a typing experience in order to get me a job reference in my field. So my friend suggested me to either you just type the story, you would either get into the industry, movie industry, or with the typing experience, I can get you a job reference in our field. So I used to send a type 2 pages daily, and I used to send a. At some point, what I felt was, okay, let's send this to some other people. She actually liked my story and way of writing. So we have combined, as you might have known, this was actually 22 chapters of small pages.
Yeah.
We have combined. So my, as I said, like web series, similar to web series, my idea was to, whenever I complete the second page of that story, they should ask for the next chapter by themselves. Because I have to make a cliffhanger. Voluntarily, I have to pull up a cliffhanger in that end of the page. I used to send her, and some other friends also, I used to send this. When they got interested, they used to ask me, oh, okay, where is the next chapter? Even though when I'm not feeling interested to write the story next day, I would write for them. So they would phone up me, oh, where is the next chapter? When will you send it? But when I got married, when I got engaged, and my priorities totally changed. They themselves also got engaged with their own work. So when people started not asking, my writing also got slowed. But again, this COVID lockdown gave me a time. One more thing, I have to mention one person. When I was working as a supervisor, there was a seller to our company. One day he kept a status, WhatsApp status in his phone. What is that means? I don't know exact words, but I'll tell the gist. Even in this lockdown time also, you didn't do anything or learn anything, something new. You have no rights to tell I don't have time.
Exactly.
That somewhat stung me. So I felt like that he was talking to me. He kept that status for me. So what I did was mainly three things. First thing, I completed this book. Second thing, I started to learn C program. And third thing, started to learn Malayalam.
That's amazing.
So what I did was, until lockdown was opened up, I started to learn. I went half of this. Only the successfully completed was the book completion. These two are still now enough. Now I can read and write Malayalam, but I don't speak Malayalam.
But that is a milestone. That like reading and writing a different language is a milestone in itself, you know. It's not very easy to do that.
So suddenly my wife got delivered. I got a baby. So he was born now. Exactly the very next day of his birthday was lockdown start initiation. The first day, trial day. So that was that day. He was there in my in-laws' house. I was here. So whenever I get a time, I used to go there. So that's what the priorities change. So I have to take care of that and something like that. After finishing the story, I sent to many people. Some of them suggested me to publish. So I have sent it to some of the printers, from local printers to few of the people I have sent it. Main was budget. Their budget was, to them actually it was lowest, but for me it was the very, very highest. So what they said was, for 1,000 copies they used to quote an amount. And I don't get any, I have to sell all those 1,000 copies.
Oh.
They have just print me and give me back the book. I have to sell everything. So I didn't have that kind of amount and reputation to sell. So what I did was, okay, let's keep this in the shelf on the shelf itself for now. But one day, suddenly, when I was actually, you know, Saranya Dandapani, until the
that then there's author, coffee. Yeah.
She was my father's colleague's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, my parents, both of my parents' colleague's daughter. She kept the status like this book status. She published it. First, she used to keep many status like reading a book, about the book, and she was totally somewhat off world, according to me. When compared to my guys here, no, she would be totally advanced for our level. So whenever she like, okay, fine, okay, yeah, that's nice, that's nice. But when I saw that name on a book, on that book, no, of her name, so then I suddenly surprised, wow, she published a book. Then I phoned up her. Actually, she didn't pick up. I have to call up her twice or thrice. Then she never picked up. Okay. I thought now she became author, she might be very, very busy. I should not disturb her. So I texted her in WhatsApp. I asked her, wow, congratulations. And please tell me the process. What is this? I also have the book. And I sent that manuscript. No, I sent to her. She read some pages and encouraged me. Okay, this is nice. You could publish with it. So then I got in contact with you and the whole process. Now we are here.
Yeah. Okay. So since we are talking about the process, would you like to like tell us how the process went for you as a beginner, in the industry, as a beginner author? How was Ink Feathers to you? Like, how did you feel the process going? Was it smooth? How was it according to you?
See, it was very, very smooth. I didn't expect this to be such ease, you know? Actually, I must thank you guys, mainly first Saranya, who introduced you guys to me, and Niharika, and yourself. And few other authors, I don't know their names, and they don't know me. So, but I'm thanking you on your behalf. So I thank them also. And it was a wonderful experience. And I would encourage, you know, something after this book got published and I kept it in WhatsApp, Facebook, the status and all. Very few people used to call me and they used to wish me, wow, congratulations, everything and all. And then I too have a story. I want to publish it. What? You are a writer? For how long?
Oh.
So, you know, yeah. How only I came to know that I have so much of writers among me, around me. Those have been so many hidden gems. So I will definitely recommend them to you guys in Feathers. It was a nice experience, and we have a long journey to go on now.
Definitely.
We will reach so much more milestones.
Exactly. And to be honest, I am very thankful that I received such a good manuscript that was Vivek's, yours.
Thank you.
That actually kept me like hooked till the end, till where the person who was the huge figure, I exactly don't remember, but there was this final boss and he was delivering a big speech, you know, in the end, where he was telling that, okay, what we are doing is wrong and all that. He was accepting, and he was accepting to withdraw and all that stuff. I will not say more because it will act as a spoiler. So yeah, so till that point of time, I was kept hooked to your story, and it was such an amazing experience, to be very honest. So thank you so much for giving us that experience. It was a nice ride. I actually had pretty goosebumps, like when some suspense scenes came up, like, okay, this person was actually missing, or this person was there, or this person was there, that person was there, something like that. So it was a great experience, to be honest. Also, Vivek, I would like to ask you if you have any recommendations, any suggestions for, you know, Ink Feathers, or for your author friends who might be watching this interview, or for young blood like us, whom you might think they might need some motivation, who are new into the writing industry, who want to start. Any message for them?
See, I don't know whether I'm qualified to
answer such question. You definitely are.
Yeah, but the thing is, one thing I want to say is, you just pursue your dream. See, we used to go, you might know my journey, how I got into this, because I didn't have enough money to publish this. lockdown also I got a family. I was totally tarnished with this. But when you put your soul and interest in your work, as many people would say, the universe would help you somehow. I don't know whether it is somewhat magical, but the thing is, I want to tell is just keep on doing. I want to just quote the speech of Gwen Stacy from Amazing Spider-Man 2. You have to try till you succeed, or else die trying. Even if you didn't succeed also, you would have the one satisfactory feel that you have tried your best. When you go down, you will go on with a smile. But if you stop trying at some point, after some years, you might think that, oh, should I have tried more? Or would it be like that? So that would create a very vast effect.
Yeah.
Very bad effect, actually. Not a good effect.
Yeah, kind of a self-guilt that I could have done. I could have done that.
At that time, we can't pursue with furthermore with our own work, what we are doing at that time. So I would suggest just blow your mind and blow others' mind.
Exactly. Wow. Okay, it was very inspirational talking to you, Vivek. I would like to end this interview right here. It was very inspirational. Vivek has been a great person throughout the journey of his book with us. And well, on a sign-off note, I would just like to say as the interview host that everyone should follow their dreams, as Vivek said. Everyone should do it. Basically, if you think that you are capable, if you think that you are not even if you are capable, actually, if you think, okay, you like doing it, then I think you should do it. So I think that would be all for the interview, Vivek.
Thank you. It was a good time speaking with you.
No. You're very inspirational. And I did not feel like it was your first time on a Zoom interview, to be very honest. Like it has been an amazing journey. Like, every time I have talked to you throughout this journey on a phone call or on the chats or anything like that, it has been great talking to you. It has been a great experience. So I would just like to end this interview on the note that I request everyone who is watching this currently to go purchase Phantom Magician and the Tiger Palace. It's available on Amazon, Flipkart, and everywhere. You can buy it on Inkfeather store, etc. Everywhere. So yeah, that's it for the interview today. Have a good day, guys. It was great to have Vivek with us.